Good morning, everyone. I am Srikant Patnaik. So first session will consist of version control. Before we start version control, I want to show you some repositories which eventually lead you to motivate why to use version control. So let me go back to browser. So this is one of the version control hosting website, and what we will do is we will see some of the good projects which are hosted on this website. So let's see, most of you know about the Linux kernel. So we will just search for Linux. So in the first link you can see it says torvalds/linux. Torvalds is Linus Torvald who started the Linux kernel project. So you can see this is the entire Linux kernel source code which Linus Torvalds, and he authored a day ago. You can see he has made modifications one day before. So you can see he has updated a day before. So what is all this? Why this website and why this Linux version control? Why these many files? What is this readme? Let us get through it. Before that, just keep in mind that these files get changed day by day, every day. People download, people contribute. It's a large community, so it's a collaborative effort in which many people contribute to this project. So let's come back to our version control topic. So we will cover these many things. Version control using Git is our main topic today. So there are many other tools beside Git that of course we are not going to cover, but they are also important. But Git is the most widely used and most fast available version control tool which we know. So let's start with what is not a version control. Before that, let's know what is a version control and official definition. So what is a version control? When you write any document in Microsoft Word or Open Office, you save it, right? Again you write something, again you save it. So that is also a version control. Let's take a simple example. This is my Linux terminal emulator. What I will do, I will open a VI editor. VI is a command line editor, and say I will write hello.txt. So this will open an empty file hello.txt, and if I write hello world and I save it, correct. So is there any version control involved here? Till now, not exactly. Again, what I decide later, no, it's not hello world, let it be hello India. Then again I save it. So far all good, there is no version control practically, but there is a revision control. You can say, so hello India is the new revision of this file. How? If I undo this, I get hello world. So this is the previous version of this file. If I redo this, I get hello India. So this is the latest version of this file, correct? Fine. So this is a revision control. This we do all the time in Open Office, in Microsoft Word, in emails. We save our emails in drafts, etc. But this is not good enough for our source code to be managed with. You can't write your source code, save and undo it to make a separate version. What happens if you deal your source code like this, or your Hello India or Hello World program with this? If I exit this editor, VI editor, by pressing Shift ZZ or colon WQ, write and quit. If I open it again, it will show Hello India. This is the latest version. But if I try to undo, it is not possible. It says already at the oldest change. That means whatever previous changes to this document I made just before, they all get lost. Why? Because I just closed the document and everything get lost. So do we want this kind of revision control for our source code to get managed? We will come to that. Not exactly, we will come to that. Fine. So let me remove this hello.txt and let me come back to our slides. So version control is also known as revision control or source control, is the management of changes to documents, computer programs, large websites and other collection of information. So it clearly states that not only source code, you can manage your any kind of document. So let's see how to do it. Means we don't use version control by default. Means this should be a default practice from now onwards, because this is very easy to use tool. Of course, it is very scalable. You can scale it to any extent. We will see just basic of that, which will get used going. So normally people get confused with version control with software versions. Say software version of GIMP 2.6. It is not a version control. It is a version of that software. So similarly, the version of OpenOffice, it's 3.6 point something now. So that is not the version control. It's the version of the software. And that number is 3.6 doesn't signify any amount of source code management done to that. Am I making sense? Okay. So it is not a version control. So what is a version control? Version control is a source code management tool which manage the changes to the document or source code, etc. So I think I made very clear what is a version control and what is not a version control. Of course, without knowing why we need to learn this software, it is just wastage of your time and mine too. First of all, for anything, we must be motivated to learn the topic. So I think this paragraph will tell you why we need a version control. First of all, with our hello.txt example, what happened? Suppose I removed the hello.txt. What happened if in your source code you accidentally remove a source file? Does it mean that your project is means over? You have lost a critical source data? If this file would have been under version control, you can retrieve the deleted file also. Isn't that good? So you can go to previous versions, you can even retrieve the deleted files also, which are of course under version control then only. So this paragraph will tell you why we should get motivated to learn this particular tool and use in our day-to-day life. The first one says reversibility. So it says that you can get back to the previous state if you discover some modification you did is a mistake or a bad idea. Of course, suppose in our case in hello.txt, we did a mistake with hello world and we just get reverted to hello India, etc., etc. But with a version control, you can easily get the previous version, even if you close the file also. Concurrency, its ability to many people modifying the same set of files or same source code, and history, means you can browse and navigate the history of the changes which you made. So what we will do, we will just focus on a particular version control tool known as Git version control, which is fast, robust and most popular tool around. So if you just search for Git in your Google, it will give you tons of results. You have lot of online documentation, you have very good support, you have YouTube videos to support. Of course, it is written by Linus Torvalds, who is the maintainer of Linux kernel, which is the single largest project in the world. Means it has more than 10 million lines of code, still adding. So if this version control tool can manage Linux kernel efficiently, you can think of what it can do with your simple projects. So I think these three, reversibility, concurrency and history, in a single word or in a single statement I can say, you can able to revert your changes, you can go to your previous version of changes, you can retrieve some lost files, and you can collaborate many people to work on the same project. So this is very important. The third statement is very important, because none of the projects, big projects or small projects done by a single person, even the Linux kernel, it is initiated by Linus Torvalds, but it is carried out by thousands of developers around the world. So unless a version control tool allows you to collaborate with people, it is not worth using. Okay, I think this is enough to motivate you why you should go for version control and why you should go for Git version control especially. Of course, I have not given you any examples of other version control tools. Let me give you a few. So there is a version control tool known as Bazaar, and there is known as Mercurial. So these are very good version control tools, but they have their limitations. So we are not going to discuss those limitations here. So our first topic for today is how to make a simple Hello World project with Git version control. Okay, so this will take hardly 5 minutes because I am explaining also, that makes it maybe 15 minutes, but believe me, initiating a program, initiating version control tool for a particular project mainly takes 2 to 3 minutes, that's it. So every step is documented here, so if you lose anywhere continuity, you can just go back and see your file. So what we will do, come back to terminal, I want to clear the terminal, so control L will clear the terminal for me. So it says Srikant at the red del. What I will do, I will just change this name and replace it with dollar sign like this. Again control L to clear the screen. So now we have cleared Linux terminal emulator. Let me do ls first to know what all files are here, though it is not required. Let me delete unnecessary files, clear the screen. Mkdir, what is the project team? Hello World. Hello hyphen world. So this will create a Hello World directory in my home. So where I am, pwd will tell me in which directory I am. It says slash home slash Srikant. So this is the home for user Srikant. So you can see clearly there is a Hello World directory, cd to Hello World. So now our present working directory says we are in Srikant Hello World, home Srikant Hello World. Let me clear the screen for you. So what we have done, we started a simple Hello World project, we created a directory, we cd into that directory. Now as the name suggests, Hello World, we will, this project indirectly says that there will be some source code inside this project which will print Hello World finally. So this directory itself communicate to user that what kind of source code or what kind of project is going to be. This is also a good practice to have a directory named after the project. So before writing the actual code, it is also a very good practice and well recommended by many experts that you start with a readme file. So readme file means the readme file should state about the project, that what that project is going to do and what kind of application it's going to host, etc. So what we will do, we will create a readme file. For those who are not comfortable with VI text editor, VI is a command line text editor, what I will do, I will use gedit just to make you comfortable. So gedit readme dot rst. So gedit is a graphical text editor. Remember, sorry, I forgot to tell you, these tools you can use it on your Windows operating system also. So this will open gedit. So I have a readme.rst and I already have written a small .rst file, readme.rst file, to save time. So what this readme.rst file says, let me copy first. If you have terminal with you, please you also practice with me. It is not showing any syntax highlights. Okay, let me discard this because I want to show you the syntax also. So let me get back to VI editor. It is, if we get time, I will tell you about basics of VI later, though it is covered in the Android advanced debugging. So VI readme dot rst. I for insert, so I am in edit mode now, fine. So let me, so escape will turn off the edit mode and if I press I or insert on the keyboard, it will again put me into edit mode, escape, get back to the command mode. So you can see there is a neat syntax here. So this is a RST file known as restructured text, which is the markup, lightweight markup language, which we will deal in at the end of this session from 2 to 2:30. So this readme is significant, though it is not nothing to do with the Git version control, but you can see the syntax of readme. Why this is important is, I have not written a single line of code, but I know what I am going to do. This is very helpful for my collaborators, because suppose I have added multiple people to this project, then they might want to know what exactly is going in my mind and what I am looking for. So this will say that, okay, there is a project known as, what is this project for? This project will create a binary executable file, which when invoked will print hello world on terminal. We will get back to the syntax of RST file later. So basically this double dots will make the header, this will be subheading, and double star will make this text bold, and prerequisite says what it requires. It requires a GNU C compiler, that's it. How to use: compile the source file and generate binary executable, name as hello. How to do that? Like this, save and exit, done. Now our simple hello world project, we have our readme file in place. So let me initiate the Git repository inside this directory. Before that, let me clear the screen, pwd, I am in hello world project. Let me do ls-la, so this will list all the hidden files also. So it says no hidden files, this dot means present working directory, this double dot means previous directory, parent directory, and only one file, readme.rst. So just initialize the repository here, single command git init. Git init will initialize empty git repository in this directory. Then you have to do git add. You might think that how I know these commands, because first of all I should tell you, right, means these commands are listed in such and such directory, etc. If you get lost anywhere, just do man git. This is the Linus Torvald documentation, you will find many funny lines here. So this will list all the commands and their use, and to get information for individual commands, you can also invoke like man git init. Just now we did git init to initialize empty repository in this directory. So let us see what is the manual entry for that. Create an empty git repository or reinitialize an existing one. Q to quit this manual page, control L to clear the screen. Let me do ls-la. So now you can see there is a directory known as dot git, which will host all your future repository files in a non-readable, non-editable format. Okay, so never ever try to edit this directory. This will corrupt your repository, or of course you will not delete this directory for sure. Now the repository in place, I have to tell the repository, I have to tell git to start tracking the file. So how many files we have in this repository? Only one, readme.rst. So what I will do, git add readme.rst, this will add readme.rst to git repository. So git will start tracking this file. Suppose you have multiple files in this directory, git won't start tracking all the files by default. You have to tell git explicitly that I want to track this file, then only git will start tracking that file. Suppose, just out of context, I will make two or three files here. Touch is a command that will create an empty file. So touch 123 will create three empty files in this repository. So you can see 123 and readme.rst is there, but I have not added file 1, 2, and 3. I have added only readme.rst. So if I do git status, it won't say anything about these three files, 1, 2, 3, you can see them, it says untracked files. What does it mean? It means Git has no tracking information, Git has been not approached to track these files. So, it also suggests you, if you have forgot to add, please add these files, git add and file name, clear? And it says there are some changes in this readme.rst which has been recently added. Control L to clear the screen. I will remove all these temporary files which are nothing to do with our project. Coming back to my documentation, okay. So, our readme.rst file is there. So, how do I tell Git to make a version of it? So far, what I did, I asked Git to add this file in the repository by git add command. So, git add will add this readme.rst file into the repository. Now, I want to say, because I have completed finishing this documentation readme.rst. So, I know this is a right time to commit these changes. What I mean by commit changes means, I want this version of file to be saved somewhere. Somewhere means in the Git repository only. So, what I want to tell Git that, okay, whatever the version of readme.rst file is there, please commit to that. So, git commit. So, now I am committing that whatever readme.rst file is there is a version, a stable version, a appropriate version to come back from future if required. So, it will open a GNU nano command line editor. So, it is asking for a commit message. So, if I want to come back to this previous version somewhere from future, then I must have some text to it, text associated to it, so that it will remind me, okay, this commit refers to this text message refer to this commit, that means, okay, I can revert back to this. Because this commit these commits will be logged as a encrypted form, you will not know the content of the file unless you revert to that version. So, it is recommended to add a commit message, so that it will tell you when you come back from the future. So, this commit message will look like this. So, you can add anything. I have added a statement like added readme.rst. What else I with instruction, yes. Your commit message should be small, precise, and it should say what exactly you want to convey yourself when you return to this. So, I want to convey myself that, okay, this version means this. So, I added this readme.rst file with instructions to compile and execute. That is it, it is basically done. So, what we have done now? We have written a commit message for this particular commit. Now, you might be wondering why this GNU nano, what is this again? You don't know VI editor, you again introduced with a new editor. Forget about these editors, you can modify this editor preferences later in your git config file. This is a separate topic, but for time being just accept these changes that somewhere it will open a graphical editor for you in Windows or in Linux also, which where you can enter these things. So, control O will write the file and control X will exit. So, it clearly states on command line that one file changed, 22 insertions in that file, plus means insertions, and created a mode for that RST file. That is it. We have successfully created a Git repository for our Hello World project. Isn't it simple? What we have done so far, we have done only these three steps. We have done git init to initialize a empty git repository in our Hello World program. Let me clear it. First command we did was git init. Then, if I do git init, it will again reinitialize it. So, I won't do. Then we did git add readme.rst. Again, we did after that we did git commit and we have given a commit message. that's it, we have created a empty Git repository. But is it enough? Like we have seen before, that Git has main advantage with collaborative project, means unless you invite people to work on your project, there is no use of a single hello world project lying somewhere in someone's computer. So let's add people to this. Okay, so there is a note here, if you want to remove any file from Git, you can use git rm that file name, because that is not part of this tutorial, so I prefer to add it in a separate note. So likewise, you added git add file name, similarly you can do git rm file name, everything is documented, don't worry, you will not get lost. So the more practical approach will be doing this on some server. So collaborating with people doesn't mean that you will share your files via email, or you will create some tar file and put it in some pen drive and give it to your friend. That is not a collaboration. What does Git offer you when we say collaboration? Git offers you a centralized server on which you can upload your files. In technical term, Git says git push, and collaborators can also push to that server. It's like this diagram. So there will be something cloud means there will be some website on which there will be repository which we will push, and this is suppose my repository working directory. I will push to this server, and someone else, maybe someone else here, will also push to this repository, someone else here will also push to this repository, and we will have collaborative coding effort, means we will be assigned multiple tasks which we decide among ourselves, or our readme will communicate. There is no particular reason that collaborators should know each other. Suppose I am here and my collaborator is somewhere in US and we never met, we don't know each other. This happens because suppose I have this project Hello World, for example, I have something better project, say I have created something, a programmer, 8051 programmer, okay, someone in some other part of the world has appreciated it and he want to contribute to that. He don't know me, he doesn't know me, then what he will do? He will just ask me for the request. He will ask me request that please add me to this project, I want also to contribute to this. So I will add him. See, if he do something bad to that project, or if he remove something, I can revert back to my previous version, I have saved copy. So every collaborator has a complete copy of the repository. So let's not move around, let's concentrate to our work now. It is best to have a server based approach rather than having a local repository. So these are the benefits. You can see, you can access your file from anywhere, you can share with people, people can communicate with you, people can see your files, they can comment on your files, etc. And of course, if you don't like any contributor, as an administrator you can manage that also. So you remember I shown you one web page, github.com. This is one of the web page, one of the website which allows you to host Git projects. There are many such, like Gitorious or Bitbucket or sourceforge.net. There are many such projects, but most of the open source people choose GitHub to host their project. You can see the best example is we have Linux project hosted on this. Linus Torvald has hosted his project on this. So this gives us some confidence that okay, this website might have some value. So what we will do, we will create a account here. I assume that you don't have account on GitHub. I do. So what I will do is I will just go to my account, so it will say what all repositories I have. So if you don't have an account, it's free, just create an account. Initial process is to create a new repository by clicking first option next to username. This is my username, and there is a first option is it says create a new repo, click on it. Even this web page is part of this documentation, you can go through this also. I have previously created a Hello World project just to make this documentation. So it says create a repository with Srikant Patnaik and repository name. Remember, this is important because we have created our repository locally as hello world, and github.com doesn't know about it. So you can't give any other name. You should give only the only possible name allowed here is hello world. Okay, the name should be same. Suppose if I started my project from GitHub itself, that is also possible. You can directly come to github.com, create a new repository, then it will give you some instruction that download that repository and that will create a local copy of it. So that is also possible. So both ways you can do. So I choose to do the previous first way. So this is a hello world, and there is a simple hello world project. You should give some description, meaningful description. It says, is it a public or private? We are open source people. Initialize this repository with a readme, not required because we are smart people. We have already created a readme, create a repository. That's it. So it says Srikant Patnaik/hello world, and this is the link for a repository. Okay. So now github.com shows me few options. It says, if you have not created locally, which I want to convey now, then it says that create a file like this, git init, git add, do these steps. Push an existing repository from command line. This is important because ours is an existing repository, isn't it? We have already created a hello world project. So all we have to do is we have to add this line. So what does our documentation says? So a new page with two options will be displayed, as we've seen. So just add this git remote add origin. Why? Because this will tell my local repository this command. Let me copy this, come back to terminal, pwd, I am still in my hello world project. This gave me a confidence that I am doing right. I will paste this command, git remote add, remote means a remote server, add origin means the URL. You can add multiple origins. https://github.com/srikantpatnaik/hello-world.git. This is the recommended thing to do. That's it. I have added my remote. Now what I will do? So we have added our server information in our local repository. We have created a repository in the server with the same name. We have copied the URL of the repository in our local repository. Then what we have to do next? Of course, we want to push our repository to server. So a simple one line command is git push will do the work. But as we are doing it for first time, you should tell which origin you want to push. So we have only added one URL. You can host your code on different websites. Suppose you have created hello world project on github.com and sourceforge.net also. Now you want to push to both the servers simultaneously, you can do that. So in our case, so we have added git remote, git push, let me clear the screen, control L, git push hyphen u origin master. So it is asking me username. So I know my username. It is asking me password, ********. That's it. So it says that a new branch is created, master, and that's it. So you want to verify? Yes, you should. Just reload this page, control R. That's it. So here is my hello world project, and this is my readme file, and you can see Srikant has authored 14 minutes ago. So it's a time when I committed. It is showing the commit time. It is not showing when I push to the server. Server doesn't have any intelligence. Whatever I commit that is local to me, whatever my collaborators commit, that will local to them. Whenever they push to server, then only they get merged. Okay. If there is some conflict between the files, suppose we will come later. So you can see that readme.rht file is now rendered beautifully as this file. So this is my heading, this is my subheadings. This hello world turned to be bold, isn't it good? Yeah, one more thing. You need not to open GitHub web page every time to push changes. This is a common practice people do. They think that unless you get online on github.com, you can't push your repository to Git. This is not true. It's nothing to do with browser. You have added your git remote add URL, then you push it, it will push. No need to get login into GitHub every time. Though it seems stupid to mention it, but it happens. Okay, so far what we have done, we have created our Hello World project locally. We committed, we have done single commit. We pushed our repository to Srikant Patnaik/Hello World. Now I am interested to add collaborators to it. Someone has approached me and he want to collaborate to this project. He want to contribute to this project. Then what I will do? I will go to github.com and in the settings tab, in the same repository, remember, in the collaborators tab, so I know my collaborator whose name is Aakash MHRD. This is a temporary account I created to just demonstrate this project. Add. So what does this signifies? This signifies that my solo project now become a multi-user project. So I have another user who will contribute to it, and mostly this user MHRD, Aakash MHRD, will create the source code for this project. So my task is to create readme file, and I asked my collaborator to create source code, logic. That's it. Now splitting the task and collaborator side. So what I will do, so you can see who am I. It's a command which will tell who am I, means which user is this. It says Srikant. So if I download the project and again try to push, Git will push from my user account only because it is saved here locally. But I don't want that. What I will do, Control Shift T, this will open a new terminal, and what I will do, I will switch user to Aakash. I have created a user Aakash on my machine. So in Linux, GNU Linux, you can have multiple users logged in at same time. Password for Aakash is, I don't know. So you can see the font, terminal color, everything changed because it takes from local bash RC, bash. So if I type CD, it will put me into Aakash@Dell. So you can see here, PWD, who am I? Is Srikant. And here, who am I? Is Aakash. That means there are two separate users presently logged in this machine. So we are not doing any mess up. So let me clear it and let me change this prompt from dollar to, or what I will do is, let me exit from this and let me create a new terminal, and I will keep both the terminals side by side so it will be easy to understand. PS1 equals to, okay. Let me resize Srikant's window also. Okay, now we have two terminals side by side. Control L will clear my both terminals. So this one is Srikant, and this one is Aakash. So what I will do, Srikant terminal already has this readme.rht. It already, of course, Srikant is admin, so has this project. This Aakash is a collaborator, he doesn't have these files. One way is I can email these files to him, okay, old way. The other way is he can download from GitHub. So there are multiple ways to download. He can click on readme.file, he can copy the content of readme.file, he can save that file in his local repository as readme.file. Is it? That is also possible. Another way is he can download this entire repository as zip. That also he can do. But as a collaborator, it is not recommended. what he has to do is he has to clone this repository. Cloning means getting the entire commit messages, logs, whatever the previous collaborators have done, everything will be carried out to the new collaborator. So cloning is the right way to get a repository. So control C to copy Aakash user now, control V. So git clone, so this will clone the repository for whom? For our collaborator Aakash. Enter. So it will throw some error, don't worry. Now you see ls, so now you can see a directory hello world in the user Aakash. Control L will clear the screen. Cd hello tab completion, press tab to get complete ls. So he has a copy of readme.rst. ls hyphen la will also show that he has this dot git directory too. That means he has the commit information which Srikant the admin has done. Fine, so let me see what does this readme.rst contains. It basically contains the same, correct. So as a collaborator I go through this readme.rst, I know my job, I have to create a source file, and the function of source file should be, it should create a binary which eventually print hello world. So this is a source file, let me copy this. So vi hello underscore world dot c, I for insert, okay. So this is a simple program which will print hello world on terminal. So as a collaborator I have completed my work. Now my job is to push these changes to server, back to server, okay. That is what the meaning of collaboration. So what all steps, control L to clear again, what all steps we should do? Do we need to do git init again? No, because git init will create a repository again, because this contain already initialized repository, we need not to create again. So the what we will do, git add hello world dot c. So this will tell local git to track hello world dot c file. So now git will track hello world dot c. You can check by git status. So it says on master changes to be committed in hello world dot c. Git push, either you can say hyphen u origin master, or as this information is already there, you can simply say git push. Now it will ask for username. So username of whom? Srikant Patnaik? No, username of collaborator whose name is Aakash and his password. Authentication failed. Let me try again. Yes, thank you. Username is Aakash MHRD, is it? MHRD. Okay, it says everything is up to date. Let me check the server. Control R to reload. Let me check the username of collaborator Aakash MHRD, correct. Git status, so this is a lesson now. So git commit will open a editor empty, okay. Now when a new user comes in, he has to configure git for first time, okay. So git suggest me how to configure that. So all you need to do this thing, in fact this is also mentioned in your document, in document also I intendedly make this error so that when you do it on first time you will get to know how to do this. So git config global username, you have to do like this. So I am just copying this. Paste, which say some, see this username and email address need not to be same of GitHub. This is nothing to do with GitHub, this will help Git to create a encrypted file with your username and email address. It will create unique non-editable encrypted files. This has nothing to do with GitHub account or SourceForge account. So what I will do, I will give some, say some email address and name I will give Aakash. So now I have successfully configured my Git to do Git commit. So let me clear the screen, Control L. Now Git commit. Okay, so what should be my commit message? Anything which signifies added hello sufficient enough. Control O to write, Control X to exit. Now the collaborator Aakash MHRD has created this file and created helloworld.c file, he has committed to it. So now in total to this repository we have two commits, one commit made by administrator who has made commit to readme.rst, the second commit is made by collaborator who has made commit to helloworld.c. So git push will push this changes to GitHub. Fine, so done, because administrator has allowed me to push back the changes, so I can push. Now let's verify again. Let's click on Hello World program, Hello World repository. You can see there is a new file, helloworld.c. You can click on that file, that will open in local repository. It says Aakash has committed 2 minutes ago. This is the commit message of Aakash. It says added Hello World C program. That's it. Fine. Now think of a situation where I have, means as an admin, Srikant Patnaik, who has initiated this project, has decided to modify the README. Okay? Most likely condition. I don't know what my collaborator did in the back end. I don't go to website all the time and I don't check whether he has pushed or not, etc. So what I decided to do, I decided to edit my readme.rst file and I want to add this last line to it. So this is Srikant again, the admin of the project. What all he contains? He contains only readme.file, readme.rst, and what is there with collaborator? He has readme.rst as well as helloworld.c. Now I decided to edit this file and I want to append this line at the end thanking my users. What will be my process? Usual process, git add readme.rst. There is a shortcut for it. See, we have not actually added a file, we have modified a file. So you can do directly git commit by command line flags like add all files which are modified and this hyphen m will tell you, will allow you to add your commit message in line. So if you type only git commit, what will happen? It will open a text editor and it will ask to enter your commit message. But I want to add all the modified files, hyphen a means add all the modified files. I know there is only one file which has been modified, and M means I want to add my commit message in line within double quotes, modified readme.rst, simply, that's it. So this is my third commit for this repository. First two commits made by me, one commit made by my collaborator. Now I will do git push. So this should push my this changes to server. Okay. Username it says error. What is the error? Failed to push some reference to server. Very well. Why failed? Same thing is documented here. So this says that there are some changes in the server which are not there in my local repository. So I can't push it. So git is intelligent. It says I will not push it unless you both, means the collaborator and the admin, have the same copy of the repository. Only one updated file can be there in the server. Clear? So my collaborator has pushed hello world.c file with readme.rst file, that is commit number 2. The copy of that I don't have, and I didn't check the server and I decided to push the file. What happened? It rejected. So now this diagram will make some sense. So this is the GitHub server. So you can see the first commit is made by me, admin. One signifies commit number. It says readme.rst I committed. Two means second step, git clone done by who? Aakash MHRD. Third step, Aakash MHRD pushed readme.rst plus hello world.c. Good enough. Then Srikant modified readme.rst and he also tried to push. Unaware of that, there is an updated version there. Now what happens? It gets rejected. Now what Srikant will do, what any collaborator, anyone will do, he will do git pull. Then he will do git push. So git pull will pull all the changes from server and it will merge if at all any merge is required. And if, okay, it will merge, simply merge, don't get into more detail. So what I will do? I will do git pull. That's what my document also suggests. Do a git pull. So git pull from Srikant side, and it pulled. And while pulling, see, we had three commits, right? The git pull will merge the both files. One with Srikant Patnaik, that hello world, and the commit means the modified version of hello world which Srikant has committed, that commit will get merged with the collaborator's commit. So there will be a new commit. So git will not modify the previous commits. Git will not say that, okay, your collaborator has committed before, so he has the priority, so you have to merge with something like that. No. When you pull anything from server and you have local commits, it will merge those commits and it will create a new commit. So if you remember this diagram, git pull will, what it will do, it will fetch the, it will internally, it will execute two commands, git fetch, which will fetch the changes from server, and git merge, it will merge the changes whatever it get from the server. So it will create a new commit. So the commit message is already written. So if I want to add something to this commit message, I can. So what I will say? I will say my mistake, I forgot to pull first, of course. So this will create a new commit which is not very relevant commit though. The relevant commits are what? Which have some changes, relevant changes. This doesn't have any relevant change. This is just a merge. Why? Because of my mistake, I forgot to pull. Control O, save, Control X to exit. Now I will do git push. Now if you see ls, now the, who am I? I'm Srikant, of course, admin. So I had only readme.rst, but after git pull, I get the changes of my collaborator also, who has created this helloworld.c. And of course, my modified readme.rst also. So git push. That's it. So now the latest version on github.com is my merge commit, commit number 4. Does collaborator has this copy? No. You understand? Collaborator doesn't know about my merge, doesn't know about my modification done to readme.rst. What the collaborator should do? He should pull the changes. So let's go to collaborator account and let's see what all he has. He has the readme.rst with no greetings at the end. Then it's a good practice to do git pull all the time when you start doing some meaningful job. So git pull will pull the changes, and the changes signifies clearly that there is a commit and there is a merge. So one file has been changed, one insertion. The insertion is the last line that is modified by admin. Now if you see what is readme.rst, thanks for using our Hello World program. So collaborator also has the updated copy. So now we can say collaborator, administrator and the GitHub server all have the same copy, right? So the second aspect of version control we will see now, which is reset. As I mentioned earlier, you can revert to previous version if you have made any changes. That's the beauty of version control. Like we have seen in our first file in that hello.txt, once you save and exit the file, you can't undo the changes. But with version control, you can easily get back to your previous state of the file, or if you are in a previous state, if you want to go to the next state, that also possible. We will just see that. To know all the commit history, there is a command known as git log --all --all space --graph. This graph is not much significant to us. This graph will show a dot, means this will show a plot. So this action, means this git reset, I can demonstrate on either way, on admin side or on collaborator side, because both have the same copy now. This we know. So control L will clear the screen. Who am I? I am Aakash. So what I will do, git log --all. So if you don't know how this flag came, what you can do, git log --help. This will display all the help commands associated with git log, or optionally you can do man git log. This will also point to the same help content. Q to quit this page. Now let's do our git log --all without adding a graph attribute. Let me unzoom a bit. So it will display all the commits. So it would be better if I could place all the commits in a single page. So basically, git, this is my command. So the topmost entry will be the latest commit. So the commit hash, you can see this is a hash of that commit, which is created from the username and email address provided by Aakash while configuring the git, not the GitHub username password, but the git, local git configuration. So latest commit shows that there is a merge of this hash and this hash. So these are 7 digits, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So only first 7 digits are sufficient enough to point a particular commit. You can point a particular commit by referring to the entire hash, but it is sufficient to mention only 7 digits of each commit hash to point to that commit. Okay, that is not relevant immediately, but we'll come to that. So this is my latest commit. I have selected it. You can see it says merge author Srikant, because Srikant has pulled and merged it, date, and this is my commit message, Srikant's commit message. So it would be better if I select up to here. So it says, by mistake I forgot to pull first. This was my latest commit, if you remember. So before that, there is a commit by Srikant only, that was third commit, which is a modification to readme.rst. So this git log will show all the logs, all the commits which is there in the repository. This could be 1000, this could be 2000 also, fine. So let's get back to our document. So it says git log hyphen hyphen all hyphen hyphen graph. Let's see what does hyphen hyphen graph will show you. Graph will make a small text based graphical interpretation that who has done what. You can see it says that this is a merge here, and this is a commit done by Aakash, and this is a separate, this is the master branch, this is a main branch on which administrator is working, admin is working, and someone has cloned here. Who is someone? Someone is collaborator who has cloned from here, and he had made a commit. What is this commit? He added a hello world.c file. Then his commit got merged here, and so this is the latest, which is common to all, collaborator as well as administrator. So this is a graphical pictorial representation of all commits and all branches, etc. Queue to quit. Now we will use the feature of git to get back to a previous version. So which version we want to reset? So this hash will not be present in this file, because this I created 2 days back, and that time my file and my content probably a little bit different. So just replace this with the commit log hash which you have now. So to simply move our head, head means the latest commit, technical term is they say head. To simply move your head to commit corresponding to readme.rst, that is our first commit. You remember, our first commit is readme.rst, which admin did. If you want to move to that, what you have to do? Git reset hyphen hyphen hard and that commit hash. That commit hash we will find from git log. So let me do git log again. So you can see added readme.rst with instruction. Now the commit message makes some sense, isn't it? So can you remember, out of nowhere, if you have 2000 commits in your repository and simply point to what you want to mean without knowing the this commit message, is it possible? Difficult. So I can recognize my commit with this commit message now. So what is my first commit message? Added readme.rst with instructions to compile and execute. This makes sense, right? So I will take the corresponding hash entry. It's not necessary that you copy exactly 7 characters. Okay, you can take some like this, not an issue. It should be minimum 7. Copy, queue to quit. Now I will do git reset. Let me clear the screen so that git reset hyphen hyphen hard and my commit hash. So it should take my version back to first version. It should discard everything else. That means there should be no hello world.c file in the directory. It's not. That means it should not have the modified version of readme which I did in commit 3. Let's verify. You can do cat also. See, it doesn't have that. What does it signify? Signifies that if a user in future thinks that whatever changes he has done to his source code or project they are not going well. He want to get back. He want to choose a previous version which is more meaningful. He want to start from here, not from some other version. He can just do git reset --hard and that commit log hash, and he can get back here. Okay, this has been done where? On Aakash user. So does administrator know about this? No, unless Aakash user push this modified version to GitHub server, the administrator won't know. Okay, so to push the changes to server, what you can do is, okay, you can check the git log again. So it says there is no commit changes, right? We haven't done any changes to commit message. Instead of all will show the all commit messages so far, but we want to know what is my present state of log message. For that, let me clear the screen. Git log. So git log will show the present state of the commits, not all the commits from the entire repository from day zero. So it's showing me only one commit, which is true, because I revert to this version by telling git that do a hard reset and come back here. So if I know what is there now, it shows me only this commit. Okay, what about the other commits? Suppose later I realize no, again I did mistake, I want to get back to that version in which my collaborator just had added hello world.c. I don't want my modifications, I want that version in which my collaborator has added hello world.c. So how to get back to that version? Simple, you will do git log --, all, because to know all the list of commits. So this is the commit I was looking for. This says author Aakash added hello world C program. Now I am where? Now my commit, because I did a hard reset, I revert to this version. Now I am here. I am this version. Now I am here. Means one version back. Now I want to go one version ahead of me by, because I want to know, I want to have hello world.c also. What I will do, I will just copy this randomly more than 7 hashes. Control L, clear the screen. Up arrow will show you the previous commands. So git reset hard, instead of this I will paste my relevant commit hash. Now it says head is now at added hello world.c. How to verify? Git log. Git log will show you the head is at, head means the latest commit. Latest commit is hello world.c now. How to verify visually? You can see your hello world.c file here. Right? So suggested reading comes here. So this is the official git-scm documentation. You can browse this. There are many, there are really good tutorials and examples here. There is a book, free book. This book is Pro Git. And if you want to practice Git online, there is a try.github.com which allows you to practice these commands online also. So that's all about Git. We will discuss about your questions during our discussion session.